Sorry about that. Where were we before you were so really interrupted? The camera battery died. You know, I knew it was low, but I figured that I had enough to make a video with, and evidently I was wrong. So we'll have to make this a two-part video. Where were we? I guess if you're more into tobacco flavor and aromatic and less aromatic, you'd probably go with this, I would guess. I think there's bite issues a little bit sometimes. I've heard some guys say there's absolutely no bite to McClellan, you know, BBC, Bill and Black Cavendish. But I don't find it to be true. I find I can get bite out of it if I want to, you know, do it, whatever. Depending on how you pack and how you puff and everything. It's not like Mac Baron or something like that. But so there's that soapy taste, I think, which I'm not real fond of. All of that's probably why I didn't order, you know, another batch of this stuff, you know, a couple years ago when I was getting low, or a year ago when I was getting low. A couple years ago, I mean now. If you get it just the right temperature in your pipe, it can be nice. It's kind of like club blend, you know, if you get the right temperature and the right cadence smoking and get it going right, just so, it'll be quite nice. But, for the big question, is McClellan's Vanilla Block Cavendish better or worse than Lane Limited BCA? Which is better? Which do I prefer? Which may have nothing to do with what you prefer. Oh, look, I pipe pointed there. I like when I do that. Look, naked woman. The answer to the question is, I prefer the Lane Limited BCA. It is, for me, for a Vanilla Black Cavendish tobacco, it is far head and shoulders above the McClellan's. It's, in fact, I say, even though I've been smoking the BCA just a week or so here, I wanted to go back and smoke it again and again. I smoke other tobaccos, and then I wish I were smoking BCA. I'm kind of thinking that I should find a go-to tobacco in a sense. I like smoking lots of different brands, but I'd really like to have like one tobacco that I smoke, on a regular basis. Pipeframe made a comment on a video here a week or two or 3 weeks ago when he was still making pipe videos. I don't know what he's doing these days. He came back making another video. I'm not sure if he's, I'm sure he'll make the case for pipe video, but I guess it wasn't a video saying he wasn't going to make more videos. He said that one of the reasons he's not going to be making more pipe videos pretty much is because he doesn't smoke a lot of different kinds of tobacco, so I really can't do reviews. He only smokes the one kind of tobacco, you know. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. I've tried so many different tobaccos the last, few years here, just because so many years I did just smoke like one or two kinds for my local. I smoked like two or three, four brands, and mainly one, which is called Hellgate Gold, which is probably one Q or something in a baggie. But really, it would be good to have tobacco, which is my favorite tobacco, because with the new laws coming up, possibly coming up, and if, no offense to you Democrats out there, but if Obama gets in the White House again, there's a very good chance we're going to see, more tobacco bans, and the FDA might get involved, and it may be very expensive to order tobacco. I wouldn't mind ordering, I'm thinking about ordering 5 pounds of that Lane BCA. 5 pounds. It's like $100-something for 5 pounds. I may order 10 pounds of it. I really like this stuff, and it's something I can smoke on a regular basis, you know, and then maybe I'll try other things too, and if I ordered 5 or 10 pounds, that would last me a long time. You know, I don't smoke my pipe every day, so that would last, I could put it away and store it in nice airtight containers. That would last me a long time, literally years and years, you know. Kind of reminds me of W.C. Fields, and W.C. Fields heard that their prohibition was happening, and this is a true story. He called the liquor supplier, and he ordered and he was a big drinker at W.C. He ordered literally a truckload of liquor, whatever he drank, whiskey or whatever. He ordered a truckload of whatever it was, whiskey or vodka, whatever. Literally, there's a movie made about him. Rod Steiger played him. In the movie, they have that scene, and literally, this van backs up to the door of his house, and he loads in case after case of liquor. And he was rich enough to be able to afford it. So literally, through the Prohibition era, as far as I know, he didn't go without drink. He had his drink. And I feel the same way about this show. If they're going to really put in harsher and harsher tobacco laws here in the States, I can't buy, 5 pounds of every tobacco that I smoke, you know. But I could buy 5 pounds of, say, Lane Limited BCA, and I could buy 5 pounds of Peter Stokkeby's Loves You Bullseye Flake, which is the other one that comes to mind for me. I might try getting a bunch of. And I could put that away, you know. I could even buy 10 pounds of each, put that away, store it and sell it very carefully, and just, I'd have my go-to tobacco for almost the rest of my life, actually. I bought a lot of tobacco in the last few years, but I really haven't really dug all of it, obviously. Obviously, I don't like all of it. You guys seem to do something I rarely ever do and don't even recommend, really, which is using my pick and my pipe. This tobacco has gotten, some of this vanilla black cabbage has gotten down the hole of my pipe down here, and it's making a noise, and it's blocking the hole, and it's driving me a little bit nuts. I hate picking in my pipe. I don't like doing that at all. Not much left anyway, but I'm going to see if I can reform that thing a little bit and get that stop. It's driving me crazy. But, relighting anyway, so. I might do that. And that's good reason. Anyway, so the comparison, back to my comparison, I think Lane Limited BCA is head and shoulders above this stuff. This is not bad. I enjoyed it when I first got it. Enjoyed it for a while. But there's a soapy taste. It's not that strong a flavor. There's a bit of bite to it. I just got a little bit of tongue bite relighting like that because, flame, used a big flame, had to light the bottom of the bowl. Not as much, filter going on. So between the two, I would say Lane Limited BCA. If you were making an order of pipe tobacco and you wanted to try one or the other, my advice would try the Lane BCA. And by the time you see this video, I may have bought 5 or 10 pounds of it myself. What I don't like about the McClellan either is it's tiny little chopped piece. At least the stuff I got was, and it tends to plug my pipe hole. It's doing it again. I don't like that. The BCA has great big huge chunks. If you watch my video on the close-up look of the BCA. So there you go. Long videos, I know. I'm sorry. I blabber on. But, I think for me, the way things are going, I need to find, same with cigars. There's about 3 brands of cigars I think I wouldn't mind having several boxes of. If they're going to, go crazy with taxes and all the rest. If they're going to make it, difficult or impossible to get my cigars online again, I can't buy them up here. It's too much money. And if they're going to do that, I can't fly down to, to North Carolina or South Carolina and buy stuff from them directly. So if they're going to, put these laws through, keep putting insane laws through, then I'm going to have to stock up. I'd like to see my video about that. That's an interesting conversation. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the review and the talk and the comparison. We will talk at you later.